Hey guys, what's up? It's Kinsey and okay.
Someone just walked in my house.
In today's video, I'm gonna be talking about not feeling like you're doing enough, not feeling good enough, comparing yourself, just being, I think just like extra critical and hard on yourself. I feel like we are all human and we can all relate to this to some extent, especially in the times that we're in. So I wanted to just do a video kind of talking about it, like a little bit about my experience and kind of how I've been coping with it, because I've definitely been dealing with this a little bit worse probably in the past like month or so. There are times when I don't compare myself at all, I don't care, I feel good about everything, and then there are times when I'm like, I'm doing nothing in life and like everything I do sucks and like nothing matters. So with that being said, I have really done some self-reflection. I know we're probably shocked, and I've realized like what it is and kind of what shifts within me when I start to compare and start to just kind of like overthink and kind of go like crazy, you know? That's like what it feels like. If you guys are new here, I'm Kinsey, nice to meet you. I would love if you would subscribe and stick around. I do a lot of lifestyle videos, vlogs, all that stuff, but I'm gonna be answering some questions slash just reading some notes that I've kind of been taking over the past, you know, month or so. It's gonna be a little bit of a rambly video, but I hope you guys enjoy. I love you guys so much, and let's get started. Honestly, I think that comparing yourselves and going through the emotions of not feeling good enough and not feeling like you're doing enough and all of that stuff is kind of part of just like being a human being. I don't think that anyone can fully escape these feelings. It doesn't matter who they are. I think we all deal with it. And so what it really comes down to is like, what are your metrics, right? So if you find your worth completely in what you're doing in your job, then obviously you're going to run into a lot of problems. We're not really gonna go into this because I've talked about this so many times, but when I was younger, I definitely found my worth more so in my worth ethic. So I would kind of just way overdo it, and I was always exhausted. Kind of like a hamster ball, you know, like you're not really going anywhere, but you're like dying. And I feel like I've really worked to kind of take my worth back and find it in something else. So for like me, I find my identity in who I am and like my faith. But for whatever you believe, I think it's just really important to not put your worth in something that is so changing and has so many different circumstances. And just like, what movie is it that says your job is never gonna love you back? I watched this recently. I just think that that's really important. Don't get me wrong, I'm so passionate about everything I do and I love working, it's like my favorite thing to do, but it cannot be like your entire life. And if you are measuring like your worth and who you are as a person by your accomplishments, like you're never gonna be happy, because you can always do more and there will always be someone who is doing more. Also, Instagram is a highlight reel, so like you never know what people are going through. I think even for myself, like in some of the hardest times of my life, like you see my Instagram and it seems fine, but that's because I'm not gonna like post crying over like a family death or something like that, which I honestly think is totally fine. I think it's important to point out often that like this is just a highlight reel, but I also don't think that you owe your followers on Instagram like photos of you sobbing over something that's like really dear to your heart. Like, you can't keep some things to yourself. But with that being said, I do think it is important to find your worth in something else, something like bigger than yourself, or even if it's yourself, just something else. I find it in my faith, and that's definitely really helped me. But yeah, then you go to like, what are my metrics? So what are you measuring your worth in? Again, what we just kind of talked about, it's like a lot of the time people find their worth in other relationships or careers or money or influence or whatever success is to them essentially. And I think you just have to keep your metrics at a very healthy thing. Like, for instance, I was getting really hard on myself recently because I was like, okay, like I've been on YouTube for forever, like my channel's not growing, my channel hasn't grown in like years and blah blah blah, whatever. And like that stuff very, very rarely gets to me, but sometimes it will get to me. Like, I'm a human being. I just remember being like, oh my gosh, like this is so not me and these are not my metrics at all. Like, that's not what I care about. I care about actually like making an impact in someone's life and whatever. And that's not to say like when you're really big you can't do that, obviously you can, but my metrics are not like hitting a million subscribers, you know what I mean? And like, while that would be great and that's cool, it matters more to me that I'm like making an impact on someone's life in like a positive way. I think just make your metrics like healthy metrics and then constantly kind of reassess in your head. Also, something I always just say to myself is like, stay in your lane, run your own race. It's so crazy, especially just in like the quote unquote like success of this world that everyone is so focused on, including myself. Things change so much. Like, people can go viral. People can like lose their job overnight. People can get a promotion. People can meet someone and that's like their ticket to Hollywood. Like, whatever that is, things are always constantly changing. I've seen it happen so many times where it's someone who was like really, really small. And let's just keep it in like social media terms just because it's easier for me to talk about. But so interesting, and I've seen this so many times when there's someone with like millions of followers that doesn't pay attention to this person with a smaller following. Probably because they have a smaller following, unfortunately, and then the person with a smaller following ends up blowing up and the other person, their channel kind of dies out. And like, now, you know what I'm saying? Like, everything is always changing. I feel like you really just have to be focused on your own race and staying in your own lane. I think a lot of people, especially in this generation, are actually like pioneers or pioneering a new way. So you can't really like look to your left and right to compare yourself, because you guys are actually all doing completely different things. Even if you are posting the same kind of content on YouTube, or you are in like the same industry or whatever that is, you're at the same school, like ultimately you are you and they are them, and they're you guys are totally two different people, and you have your own races to run. Like, you can't compare your race because no one else has your race. You know what I mean? It's just designed completely for you. So I think staying in your lane is really important. Run your own race, like keep your head down, focus on what you're doing, and don't get caught up in what everyone else is doing. A lot of people were asking about comparison and just perfectionism. And I think it's really important to just add, like, you are your own person and that's why it works. Keaton said this so well recently in her podcast, and she was like, you know, Kinzie and I make similar videos, a lot of similar videos, but like, Keaton is Keaton and I'm me, you know, like, we are two different people at the end of the day, and there's gonna be different people that collaborate with her and then different people that collaborate with me, and there's just different opportunities because we're two different people. It's really important, do not wait until things are perfect. Things are actually never perfect. Perfectionism is like this weird kind of like trap that just kind of holds you back, I think, literally from like your destiny at the end of the day, because you don't act on anything because you're waiting for things to be absolutely perfect. I am a big fan of like launch now, adjust later. Skinny Confidential always talks about that, but I definitely think that's really great. Like, specifically in regards to starting a YouTube channel, people are like, oh, I don't know. And like, the hardest part really is starting, and it's making your first video. So I think it's just really important to like jump into things. No one's perfect. I also think like no one actually wants something to be absolutely perfect, because if it's perfect, it's unattainable. So people don't connect and they don't relate to that. I think it's important, like, just go ahead and take a step, essentially, is what I'm saying. Also, I wish I could remember where this came from and what book I read this in, but I think so often, like, God just needs us to take a step in order for him to do what he's doing. It's like we're praying and praying and praying, and he's like, okay, like, I've clearly outlined this, like, just take a step and I'll meet you there. Not that God ever leaves us, but he's just waiting for us to take a step. I just think it's like incredibly important to just kind of step out in faith, and whatever you believe or however you live your life, like, just trust that things are gonna work out. Someone was asking me, how do you feel about instant stars like James Charles or Emma Chamberlain in comparing success and all that stuff? Okay, I think it's important to point out that, like, quote-unquote instant stars are, like, literally, like, 1% of the population, if that. That's actually probably too high. It's so rare that people blow up at that speed. And honestly, when it comes to, like, other people's success and when I'm, like, comparing or whatever, I'm never wanting someone else to not succeed. Like, that's not what it is. I always cheer other people on. I always want other people to succeed. Like, there's enough success to go around for everyone. Like, it's not this innate thing where there's only this amount and we have to cut it this way, and it's like, oh, sorry, there's none for you. Like, that's just not how it works. There's 7 billion people on this planet. So I'm like incredibly happy for them, and I love Emma. I think she's like the cutest person ever. There's just enough room for everyone at the end of the day. Like, just because someone else is doing really well doesn't mean that you can't do well or that you shouldn't be happy for them. Or I think it's also really ugly to like be like that. What I will say that I do sometimes is I see, not things like that specifically, because they just do totally different things than I do, but I will compare myself to others in a way that I just put more pressure on myself. So I'm happy for them and I'm like, that is so freaking cool, like, I'm so happy for you. But then I'll go back and just put a lot of pressure on myself and be like, oh, I have to be there. So for a bit, I think I didn't really compare because I didn't like wish bad upon anyone, but instead I would just place a lot of pressure on myself. And that's when I'm like, okay, run your own race, stay in your own lane. Like, your life is your own, your walk is your own, and your journey is gonna be different than everyone else's. The main realization I've made in the recent weeks, just in regards to comparing myself, not feeling good enough, not feeling like I'm doing enough, thanks to COVID, is that I only ever feel this way if I'm already not in the best place, if I'm not already like mentally and physically taking care of myself. So I have to be in a more vulnerable place for this to even affect me in the first place. When I'm a really happy, healthy individual, when I'm in my routines and I'm doing things that make me and just feeling good about life and myself, like I'm not gonna really waste my time like comparing and putting more pressure on myself because I'm in a healthy place. But when I'm not like, you know, doing my like daily devotions and working out and talking to friends and like spending time with people that I love and doing things that kind of refuel me, then I'm in a more vulnerable place where I will really get in my head and like kind of just spiral out of control. There's a really good book by Jenny Allen called Get Out of Your Head. I will link it down below. I really, really recommend it. If you deal with like any toxic spiraling thoughts, it is life-changing. Let's say you're already in a bad place. I made a list of things that help me and things that I do. I actually did this last weekend to just kind of get myself like right and get myself back to just being me. The first thing, a social media break is really, really great. Just delete the apps off of your phone. You won't miss it. It's actually so relaxing. You feel just like so calm and zen. And it's a great thing to do. I definitely recommend it. And I actually will regularly just put a social media break into my routine, but I hadn't really done that in 2020. And then I got so in my head and I was so like negative and whatever. And I realized it's because I have not taken any breaks from social media all year. And last year I would do it just periodically, like not even when I felt like I needed it. Like I wasn't even on E at that point. So I kept myself healthy. This year I waited until I was on like whatever below E would be. And then I did it. So I definitely want to just kind of make it a practice more in my life where I just regularly do it so I don't have to wait until I feel like I desperately need it and I'm like cleaning on for like air, you know what I mean? Another thing, get outside. Going on walks, like literally anything, even going on drives, there's something about getting outside. If you live somewhere where it's like beautiful outside, go outside as much as possible. There's something about being outside that just makes you feel so much better, except for when it's 105 degrees. Clear your head. For me, that really goes with just like going on a walk. I'll listen to a podcast or something and it gets me out of my own head and I'm like, okay, there are like bigger things in this world than like me being upset about this for no reason when I'm already like so grateful for my life. The next thing would be actually like a gratitude list, which like I know for some people can sound cheesy or whatever, but gratitude lists are actually really incredible because you have to sit down and actually write out things you're grateful for, and it's really hard to not get put in at least a little bit better of a mood when you're writing a gratitude list. Like it always makes me feel better. Regularly just starting off your day with gratitude list is also really good. I'm not the best about that. I actually need to do that and be better about that, but that definitely helps me a lot. Okay, get a hobby. That kind of sounds harsh. I don't mean like that, but for me, cooking and reading have definitely become like really big hobbies of mine in 2020. I do them all the time. They make me so happy and I'm just like refreshed and refueled. I think make your own goals and make your own metrics. That is really, really important. And then define your worth outside of your doing. That is pretty much it for my like comparison video. And I also just want to say, I don't know what it is about this like generation. Actually, yes, I do with social media, but I put so much pressure on myself to do something by a certain age, and like I don't even know why, because when you really think about it, it's actually dumb. But you see these like 16-year-olds like buying like Lamborghinis or whatever, not that I ever care about buying a Lamborghini, but you know what I'm saying, on Instagram, and you're like, oh my gosh, I've done nothing with my life, when that is not true, that is not the case, and that's also not the norm. I want to have like longevity in my career and in my life, and I want to be doing things that I love and I'm excited about at 40 too. Like I don't want to accomplish everything right this second, so I think enjoying the journey is really important. There's going to be times when you look, there will be a time when you look back at this and you're like, I'm so glad that this didn't happen then, or this didn't happen now, and I totally see that now. There are so many people who didn't even realize what they wanted to do until they were like 35 years old. So I think it's just really important to focus on yourself and focus on who you're becoming over like what you're doing, and just put yourself in a really healthy mindset and have a healthy relationship with yourself so that you're in a better place in order to kind of fight against comparison or fight against insecurities or feeling like you're not doing enough and like you're not enough. I really do think you at least have like a really big advantage when you're in a healthier space than when you kind of just let yourself go and you just hate everything and you're just in a bad kind of mindset. So that's kind of what I have learned just recently, and just things I'm trying to implement a little bit more to make sure that I'm not just waiting until I'm on E to like do all these things in a weekend and try to like revive myself. I want to just do them like routinely and keep it up so that I'm in a healthy place, so that I'm not putting unnecessary, unneeded pressure on myself and just being harder on myself than I already am. But I love you guys. This is a human thing, unfortunately. I really don't love it, but I love you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Let me know if you guys liked it, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.